Good evening, everybody. Today I shall be discussing about how to prevent forearm complication in transradial interventions. And I will be focusing on a very simple, newly developed technique to prevent forearm complications. There are so many complications which can a patient develop after transradial PCI. The commonest are radial artery span, excess site hematomas, forearm hematomas, and radial artery occlusion. And this is the main culprit. If you have this thing, your patient, if you cannot have complication, patient may develop compartment syndrome and can be a catastrophe. So recently I developed a technique which is given name pigtail assisted tracking of the guide catheter. So before going into the details of this technique, I will like to show you a case. The patient was a 61-year-old female with past history of stenting through the right femoral approach. And she was presented to us with recent onset angina and ECG echo was normal. So she was taken up for coronary angiography. And while this time we took the radial approach. So during the radial angiography, the diagnostic catheter could not be negotiated through the radial artery. And patient complained of severe chest pain, severe arm pain. And even the 3-5 wire, that could not be crossed through the elbow region. Then the radial artery angiogram was done, and which showed a 360-degree loop. So then a termo wire was taken, 3-5 termo wire, and it passed easily under the vision, and it has straightened the loop. And after that, the angiography was completed, which showed a severe lesion in the LAD with patent stent in the RCA. So the plan was to do a transradial angioplasty of LAD. So when we took the guide catheter, could not be negotiated into the through the radial artery. And patient complained of severe arm pain. And every time we were pushing the guide catheter, patient complained of severe pain. So multiple doses of cocktail were given, but there was no effect. So we suspected that there is a razor blade effect. So what is the razor blade effect? When we have a 3-5 wire in the guide catheter, there is a wide free space. Wide free space in the guide catheter, between the wire and the guide catheter. You have a free edge of the guide catheter, which is, will remain in the touch with the radial artery. And this this edge of the guide catheter, it produces the injury into the radial artery. So this is the basic mechanism of this razor blade effect. This is the diagram. And this razor blade effect is especially noticeable if your patient has got some tortuosity in the radial artery, because in that particular part, it may give, it has a propensity to give injury into the radial artery. What I did is, I inserted a pigtail catheter inside the guide catheter. So by doing this, pigtail basically is a longer catheter than the guide catheter. So both hand of the pigtail catheter were outside the guide catheter. Distal end was out of the distal end of the guide catheter, and the proximal hub of the pigtail catheter was outside the guide catheter. So it is making a assembly, pigtail plus guide catheter assembly, and the basic benefit was that it is basically obliterating the free space in the guide catheter. So by doing this, I have avoided the razor blade effect. And this assembly went inside very easily. And this was the real time crossing of the radial loop using this pigtail and guide catheter assembly. And it was negotiated easily through the subclavian artery and finally into the ascending aorta. And then the wire and pigtail was taken out, and the angiography was angioplasty was completed. This was the basic mechanism of benefit. Now you can see there is a smooth tapering. This is the guide catheter. This is the guide catheter, and this is the pigtail, and this is the wire. So it is making a smooth tapering. So by doing this, you are avoiding this razor blade effect. And this is the cut section of the same phenomena. This is the guide wire, and this is outer one is the guide catheter, and between these two this is the pigtail catheter. So pigtail catheter is basically obliterating that space and avoiding the razor blade effect. And then the angioplasty was completed in usual way, and the radial angiogram again showed no injury by doing this procedure. In another patient, there was a tortuosity and simple guide catheter could not be negotiated, and by this technique it was easily this is the guide catheter which is not going, and the same patient, now the pigtail guide catheter went very easily, angioplasty was completed. This was another patient in which there was a severe long segment spasm in the radial artery, and guide catheter was not going and the assembly went very easily. And the post procedure, there was complete relief of the spasm. In another patient, there was a focal radial artery spasm and guide catheter was not going, but this technique worked very well in that particular patient. In another patient, actually, when we completed the angiography, there was a radial artery perforation and the severe spasm. And then we did this same technique and the angioplasty was completed. And after completion, the radial artery angiogram showed complete relief of the spasm as well as the sealing of the perforation.
How sealing?
And now we have evaluated this technique in a prospective randomized trial, and which has clearly shown that if you do transradial angioplasty, you can reduce the forearm complication rate by 50%. So to conclude, during transradial angioplasty, sharp edge of the guide catheter may act like a razor blade and can prevent the catheter navigation and is the major reason for the development of forearm complications. And it is especially common in radial artery loops, tortuous radial arteries and small caliber radial artery and radial artery spasm. And this PET technique can overcome this razor blade effect by pigtail working as a dilator of the guide catheter. And it is very easy to perform, and it provides a non-traumatic negotiation of the guide catheter and should be the technique of choice in such a situation to prevent forearm complications. Thank you.